ADD or ADHD? Is it the same or is it different from each other? That's what I want to talk about in this video, as there's quite some confusion on this topic. For years, if it came up or people asked, I said I have ADD. And to explain it to them quickly, I said it is like ADHD, which they usually know, but without the H or hyperactivity. But in truth, there is no ADD, as ADD is an outdated term from 1980. It used to be the official name for ADHD. And there they had two subtypes, ADD with hyperactivity and ADD without hyperactivity. Then, in 1987, they changed it to ADHD. But then they did not differentiate between the subtypes. And then finally in 2000, they came up with the three subtypes. Inattentive type, hyperactive type, and a combined type. Nowadays, ADD is used unofficially to describe ADHD inattentive type. Usually, a picture of a daydreamer comes up. They cannot stay focused in class and looks out the window a lot. They are not hyperactive or impulsive. The problem with this is that when people hear ADHD, they usually have a stereotypical image in their mind of someone who cannot sit still, talks a lot, is impulsive, and interrupts people mid-sentence. Therefore, ADD goes a lot more undiagnosed than ADHD. I only got my diagnosis when I was 18 and only found out because I had it as a subject in class during my education for becoming a social worker. Because people write off symptoms of ADD as lazy, stupid, a daydreamer, or forgetful, this can cause a lot of problems in the lives of the undiagnosed. It certainly did in mine before I was diagnosed. As you can come to believe these labels, this can bring a lot of problems with it, like depression, low self-esteem, low self-worth, and anxiety. Boys versus girls. Now I want to take a look at the difference between boys and girls. Boys are 3 times more likely to get an ADHD diagnosis. At first glance, you could say ADHD is therefore more prevalent in boys. However, the one difference is that when girls are diagnosed, they are twice as likely to be diagnosed with predominantly inattentive ADHD, aka ADD. Therefore, it is speculated that ADHD is underdiagnosed in girls, because the symptoms of the inattentive type are more internal and therefore easily mistaken for a learning disability or laziness. The symptoms in girls, but also the inattentive type, include being isolated or not wanting to communicate with other people, having anxiety, difficulty learning, low self-worth, difficulty in school, think about grades and homework, disliking mundane tasks, daydreaming, trouble focusing, appearing not to listen, and verbal aggression, such as teasing and taunting. Now, of course, this is not a rule, as there are girls and women who have the hyperactivity type, and there are boys and men with the inattentive type, like myself. In boys, the symptoms are more often like what people think of when they think of ADHD, such as being hyperactive, such as running around, being impulsive and not thinking before they act, not being able to focus, being physically aggressive, talking too much, interrupting conversations or activities, and being unable to sit still. Then, we also have the combined type, where you have both the inattentive and the hyperactive symptoms. ADD treatment versus ADHD treatment. Now, I want to take a look at the difference in treatment. Usually, we don't look at the gender to see what treatment to use, but at the subtype of ADHD. The type of treatment recommended will depend on a variety of things, including which symptoms are most prevalent, the age of the person, personal preference, and what kind of treatment they had before. Because of the different types of problems that present themselves between ADD and ADHD, the coping mechanisms and strategies used will also be different. In ADD, or inattentive type, these include building good habits and routines, and learning how to stick with them, getting rid of external distractions during exams, homework, or work, finding or creating your passion, or having an accountability partner. In ADHD, this can include behavioral therapy, finding a positive creative outlet, and relaxation techniques such as meditation and breathing exercises. Although a lot of these techniques and strategies overlap and can be used by both types. In terms of medication for both ADD and ADHD, the same medication is used, like methylphenidate, aka Ritalin, and dextroamphetamine and such. Then there are some supplements that are used to mitigate some specific symptoms of the inattentive type and some specific symptoms of the hyperactive type. I made a video on this before and I will link this in the description and at the end of the video. So I hope this clarifies some confusion about ADD versus ADHD. One more thing I want to say is that I am coaching a person with ADD or ADHD for free for 3 months. All you need to do is comment and subscribe, and I will pick a random person from this group every 3 months. You can also like if you want, which will be greatly appreciated, but I will not use it as a requirement. Thank you very much, and I will see you in the next one.